everyone, it's Lisa Mears here for Pretty Pink Posh. And today I'm going to be making some Easter treat bags as well as some mini cards using the Easter Circles stamp and die set. So here's a look at the stamp set. I stamped all of the Easter circles. There are six of them in total. And inside each one of the circles is a different image. So we have an Easter bunny holding a carrot. There's an Easter basket with some eggs. There is a flower. There's also three sets of Easter eggs, which my hand is covering that one up, but you'll be able to see it here in a moment. And there's also a chick with a cracked Easter egg, and there is also a flower bouquet at the very bottom. I think these images are so adorable, perfect for your Easter or your spring cards. You can actually use these stamps with the matching dies to cut the circles out like I did in my project today, and use the circle image with the cute little image inside. Or if you wanted to fussy cut out the images inside and not have that circle along the outside, so that's an option too. You can actually take all of these stamped images, like the Easter bunny or the Easter eggs or the Easter basket, and make a cute little scene by just fussy cutting those images and making a cute little card with those images. So here I'm just showing you the coloring of all of my circles, and I am using my Zig Clean Color Real Brush pens to do some coloring. So I'm basically doing some watercoloring. And I stamped out my images using a black archival ink because that's what I use when I do watercoloring. And I stamped it onto some Bristol Smooth cardstock. I will have a list of all of the colors that I used in the corresponding blog post. So if you're interested in these colors, you can check that blog post out. So basically what I'm doing for most of these images is I'm using one color. So for example, for this flower, I used the fluorescent pink color, and then I came in with the blender and just blended that color out. Now if you happen not to have the blender marker, you can always come in with a paintbrush with some water on the tip, or a water brush, and blend the color out with water. But by using the blender, I don't need to add water because the blender will blend the colors without the water. So I'm moving on to the Easter chick, and I'm just outlining that chick with the lemon yellow Clean Color Real Brush pen, and then I'm coming in with the blender and just blending that color towards the middle. And then I'm going to come in with the fluorescent pink. I'm going to outline that Easter egg, and then I'm going to take my blender and I'm going to blend that color out. When you use your blender, or if you're using a water brush, you want to make sure that you clean it off on a paper towel before going into another color, because if you don't, you'll have the leftover color that you used previously on the tip of your brush, and then you'll end up blending colors that you don't want blended. So always have a paper towel nearby when you are doing some watercoloring. Notice that I also created a little scene background on these stamped images. So I added some green to the bottom to make it look like the egg is in the grass, and then I added a blue sky just by using the light green marker for the grass and the light blue marker for the sky. Now, if you didn't want to add that background coloring, you certainly don't have to. You can leave it white. Next, I'm going to move on to the three Easter eggs, and I'm going to color the circles of the one egg in the turquoise green color, and I just outlined the outside of the circles, and then I'm just coming in with the blender to blend that out, and then I'm going to come back in with the fluorescent pink and just outline the outside of those circles, and then come in with the blender and fill that in. I think coloring with these Zig Clean Color Real Brush pens or any watercolor that you might have is so easy because you really can just put one color down and then use a blender or a water brush to drag that color out to make it look like different shades of that one color. Now, if you wanted to use different shades of, for example, purple on this Easter egg, you most certainly could do that. You can add a dark color along the bottom and then come in with a mid-tone color of the same purple shade and then blend those two out. But for this, I made it super easy and I just used one color here and then blended that one color out with the blender. So here I'm coming in with the orange as well as the turquoise green and blending those out. And then I will just color in the background. I'll do the light blue for the sky, and I will do the light green for the grass. And then I'll just add the blender just to blend that color out. And then for the last one, which is the Easter basket, I just outline all of those sections of that Easter basket with the mustard color, and then I come in with my blender and I just blend that color out. Again, make sure that you clean off that blender or your water brush before blending that out, because it had that green from the previous stamped image on the tip of that marker. For the eggs, I used the turquoise green in the middle. I used the English lavender on the left, that's the purple color, and then the fluorescent pink for the egg on the right. I also used orange and lemon yellow for the bow, and I added a dot of the fluorescent pink in the center, and then I'm just adding the grass, and then I will add the sky. Notice I also filled in the inside of that Easter basket, so that it looks like the sky is behind it. Finally, I come in with a white gel pen and just add some accent colors to the Easter eggs. It's a little bit hard to see on camera, but I do put some accent marks there on the three eggs. And then I also come in with the flower and add a few accent marks on those petals. So here's a look at the matching die set. This die set is actually three parts, and this circle is used to die cut the stamped images. And I'm going to go ahead and take my wire cutters and just cut this circle off of there, and then cut out the middle circle that's inside of the larger fancy die. The middle circle has a stitched line that goes around the circle. And then you also have this label die that has stitching on it as well. So I go ahead and use this smaller circle die, and I die cut all of those circles. And I also took the stitched circle and die cut a piece of solid yellow cardstock. And then I took a piece of pink cardstock and die cut this label die. So you can see the stitching on that. It's so pretty. So here's what this would look like layered together. So you can see that the stamped image, the circle is slightly smaller than the stitched circle, and those would just layer just like that. Isn't that super cute? So next I'm going to create the bag topper for my Easter treat bags. Now I'm using a stencil and just stenciling some polka dots on my blue cardstock. This is the Pretty Pink Posh mini polka dot stencil, and I'm just using some white pigment ink to stencil on some of these white polka dots. And I chose to use the stencil because I wanted to have a very delicate pattern for my bag topper. So my cardstock measures 3 1/8 by 4 1/2. And then once I have that all stenciled up, I'm gonna remove the stencil. You can see how pretty that is. And I put it in my scoreboard along the 4 1/2 inch side, and I just score it at 2 1/4. And then I fold that paper in half at the 2 1/4 inch score. So now I'm going to put these bag toppers together. I'm gonna go ahead and layer on my stamped circle image. I chose to use the Easter basket here, but you'll see that I use all of them for several different bags. And then just layer that onto the yellow circle, and then layer that onto the label. And then I will add the label to the front of the stenciled topper that I just created. I'm going to stamp out a sentiment that says Happy Easter. This sentiment is from the Easter Signs stamp set. And then I just cut that out with my scissors, just fussy cut it out, and then I attach it with some foam to my label. And here I have some Easter grass. I'm just cutting it up so that it doesn't have any really long pieces. And I have these little Ziploc bags that measure 3 inches wide. So I just fill the bag with the Easter grass, push that grass all the way to the bottom, and I picked up some chocolates. They are wrapped chocolates, and I just put a couple of them in the bag, and then I will close that Ziploc up. And then I'm going to use some double-sided tape and just put some double-sided tape on the inside bottom and on the inside top of that label that I created, and then I'm going to add my Ziploc bag filled with the treats and close that up. Isn't that adorable? This is a perfect idea for children at Easter time. You can even make a bunch of these to give out to friends and family, as well as coworkers, just to let people know that you're thinking of them at Easter. So next, I want to quickly show you how I made these shaped mini cards. So to make the base of the card, just take a piece of cardstock and fold it in half. Once it's folded in half, I just take my bone folder and press down that fold so it's folded really well. And then take the larger label die and just put it slightly above the fold in the cardstock and add some washi tape just to hold that down. And when you run it through your die cut machine, it will come out and you will have a shaped card. Notice though that the top of the card base is flat, and that's from where you had the die extending beyond the edge. So to fix that, just take the label die again and die cut another piece of the same color cardstock, and that will just go right on top so that you will have a complete design on all four sides. And that's how you make the shaped card. So then you just need to add your circles and then add the circle to the individual label die cut. So I'm going to add that there, and then I'm going to add that to the card base. And then my card is complete, but I will go ahead and add a sentiment to the front. The sentiment says Easter greetings, and that's also from the Easter wreath stamp set. So I hope you enjoyed my video today. If you did like this video, please click that thumbs up button. If you are interested in any of these products, please check the description box below, as there will be links to the products featured in this video. Thanks so much for watching, everyone, and have a great day. Bye-bye.